Hey everyone! In my previous video, we looked at how to create custom icons for the Flipper Zero main menu. In this video, I'll show you a couple ways you can add new items to the main menu. The approach varies by firmware, so I'll start with the official firmware and then we can look at other firmware. Let's get started! For the first step, we'll be adding a custom icon to our firmware. Hopefully you already watched my previous videos on setting up your development environment and on adding custom icons to the main menu. I'll put a link to those videos in the comments, which I encourage you to watch before watching this video. We'll go into Assets, Icons, Main Menu, right click on Main Menu, then choose New Folder. Type unitemp_14 and press Enter. You'll recall from the previous video that there's frame PNGs and there's a frame rate. Right click on the frame rate, choose copy, right click on unitemp 14 and choose paste. You can copy and paste frame 01 PNG into unitemp 14, and then you can edit the images as before. In my case, I've already created an assets folder with the 5 images I want, so I'm going to go ahead and copy those into unitemp 14. So you can see that each image has progressively filled in thermometer. And the frame rate is set to 3 frames per second, which is fine. Control Shift B, and then debug build. So that'll take a minute, but it'll build our A_unitemp_14 animated icon that we can use in the future steps. Now let's update our firmware code. Open Applications, Services, Loader. For official and unleashed firmware, open the loader_menu.c file, and next find the loader_menu_build_menu function. This code loops through each of the applications, adding them to the primary menu, and then it also adds the setting application to the primary menu. Right click on Flipper_apps and choose go to definition. You can see that each application has an app, a name, and an app ID. Different firmwares use different names and different app IDs. In particular here, we'll look at GPIO, and it's using a name of GPIO all caps and an app ID of GPIO lowercase. So we'll write the code to add unitemp right after the GPIO application is displayed. So after menu add item, we'll write if stir comp, which compares two strings, GPIO all lowercase, and then we'll do Flipper_apps, and then in brackets, I dot, and this time we'll check the app ID, and == 0 means that the two strings are the same. And if they are the same, so the app ID is GPIO, then that means we want to add our application right after it. So we'll go to primary menu, and then here we'll change the display to be unitemp ext app. You can use any display text you'd like here. We'll change the icon to be A_unitemp_14, which is that new animated icon we just created. And the next is the index. And so we're going to do something special here in just a minute. And then next we have the menu loader callback. And then we have our loader menu. So instead of passing the index, what we're going to do is type in UINT32_T, which is a 32-bit number. And then we're going to do /ext/app/GPIO all caps /unitemp.fap. And then make sure there's a comma at the end of the line. So over in QFlipper, let me go ahead and navigate. So here's our SD card. That's the ext. And then we'll go into apps, all lowercase, and then GPIO, all capitals, and then unitemp.fap. So there's, make sure all the case is exactly the same as that path, and it should be good. Next, we're going to right click on loader menu callback, and then choose go to definition. Currently, the code sets the name variable based on Flipper apps bracket index.name. We're going to change that to parentheses index less than Flipper_apps_count? Question mark. And then if it's true, we're going to return the index.name. Otherwise, we're going to return open parentheses char star close parentheses index, which is going to take that index and convert it back into the character string. So this code's going to set the name and then call click callback, passing the name and the context. Over in loader.c, you'll find a loader menu click callback method. And this method is registered with our loader menu set click callback. So that's why this method's going to get invoked. So we'll go ahead and modify this method to do an if check for name, a bracket 0, equals equals a forward slash. And if it does, we'll do this code. Otherwise, we'll do the original code. So put that in there. So I'm going to right click on loader start to show you that code and go to its definition. You don't need to do this step. We can see that it takes the name and the arguments, and it's going to end up creating a message with those name and arguments and then queuing the app. So for our arguments, instead of null, we want to pass name, which is actually the path to the application we're trying to run. And then instead of name, we're going to pass applications, which is the name of the applications in this firmware for the applications app. Let me show you that. So if we go into it and we go down in the menu, this is the applications app, the app named applications. And when we normally go into it, we go into a path. So it's going to go into that GPIO for us because of ext apps GPIO. And then it's going to know that it's the temperature sensor reader application based on that FAP file. Okay, with all those changes, do Control Shift B to bring up the menu and say debug build. That's going to do a build. That'll take a minute. And then Control Shift B again and do flash USB without resources. In some firmwares, you may have to use flash USB with resources. Once it's deployed, press OK to bring up the main menu and scroll down. And then after GPIO, you should see the Unitemp EXT app with its animated icon. Pressing the OK button should launch the application. There it is, no sensors found. And then we can go ahead and press the back button to exit. Next, we'll look at the steps for adding an application to the main menu in Squashware firmware. Adding the frame PNGs and the frame rate file is the same for all the firmwares. We're going to go into Application Services Loader, loader.c. I've turned on highlighting on my changes. You're going to look for loader underscore build underscore menu inside of loader.c. And we're going to add our if statement right after menu add item. So we'll do our string compare with GPIO against flipper underscore apps of I dot app ID. And if that equals 0, they're the same. We'll call menu add item with the primary menu. And then we'll pass the name Unitemp EXT app. And then we'll pass our animated icon, A underscore Unitemp 14. The index isn't used, so we'll just use I. We'll pass loader menu ext callback, which is a method we'll be writing in a minute. And then for our context, we'll pass void star of slash ext slash apps slash gpio all caps slash unitemp.fap. So before I show loader menu ext callback, I'd like to show you the code for loader menu callback. So we'll go into that. So the index is unused. The application is our context. We have a couple of asserts. And then we check if the loader is locked, and then we call loader start application, passing the application and then null for our parameters. Our loader menu ext callback also doesn't use the index. Our context is the path to the application. We check if the loader is locked, and then we find the application called applications, and we assert that we found it. And then we call loader start application of applications and passing it that path to our FAP file. So now when we click OK, we can go down and below GPIO is our Unitemp EXT app with our animated icon. Next, we have RogueMaster firmware. Again, for the assets, they're just the frame PNG files and your frame underscore rate file. We've gone ahead and added an animated icon for Blackjack 14 with these four images and a frame rate of 2. This time we'll open Applications, Services, Loader, and then Loader underscore menu.c. The changes are highlighted. This time we're going to look for Loader underscore menu underscore build underscore menu. So this time we'll add our if statement. If strcomp GPIO all caps with flipper apps sub I dot name, if that equals 0, then menu add item with the primary menu, unitemp ext app, our animated icon, a underscore unitemp underscore 14. And this time we're going to use uint32t with the path to our FAP file, ext apps GPIO unitemp.fap. We'll use loader menu external apps callback as the parameter, and then void star menu as our context. And loader menu external apps callback is a method that already existed before, and it expects that the index is a uint32t with the path to the FAP file. I'm going to right click on Flipper apps and go to definition. And you'll notice the app IDs are different here. For example, this one has a FAP, the sub gigahertz has a FAP, and the GPIO has a FAP for the app ID. So be sure to always check the name and app IDs when you're doing those if statements. So RogueMaster and Extreme Firmware support external apps. We're going to compare the path of that app with blackjack.fap. If it matches, we'll do the same thing as the original code, but we'll swap the icon out with a underscore blackjack underscore 14 to give us that animated icon. For that path, we can go into ext apps games capital G and then blackjack capital B capital J. And so that's the same as the path we're comparing. Make sure the casing's correct or else it won't match. So here you can see the unitemp ext app below our GPIO. Next, we'll go to CFW settings, click OK, then click OK on interface, and then go down to main menu and click OK, and then go down to add app. We'll go into games, and then we'll choose blackjack. Press the back button, press the back button again, and press the back button again. Press OK. And then we'll scroll down, and below GPIO, we see the Unitemp EXT app. That's because of this code here. And then we'll keep pressing the down button. And then there's our blackjack game with our animated icon. And the animated icon is there because it matched the FAP file with our if statement. The process for Extreme Firmware is very similar to RogueMaster. The method is loader menu build menu. I'll right click on Flipper apps and say peak definition. And you can see the name and the app IDs also have some paths in them. And the paths are slightly different between the firmwares. So we'll add if strcomp GPIO all caps with flipper app sub I dot name equal equals 0. Then we'll call menu add item, passing loader menu primary menu, unitemp ext app, our animated icon, a underscore unitemp underscore 14, our uint32t of ext apps gpio unitemp dot fap, loader underscore menu underscore external underscore callback, and void star loader menu. Extreme Firmware also supports external applications. So we'll add an if statement looking for ext apps capital G on games, blackjack all lowercase dot FAP. And if that matches the app, we'll do the same thing as the original code, but replace the icon with our animated blackjack 14 icon. And again, for that path, we'll go into SD card. You'll see apps capital games, and then blackjack FAP you can see is all lowercase. And so that's why it's important we also use lowercase on our if statement. We'll go ahead and press OK. We'll go down to GPIO, and there's Unitemp EXT app with our animated icon. If we press OK, it launches the application. Back goes back to the main menu. And then we can go down to Extreme and click OK. OK on Interface. Go to Main Menu and click OK. Go to Add App. Choose Games. And then go down to Blackjack. Press OK. We can go press back, back, back. Press OK. And then press up. And there's our Blackjack with our new animated icon. So now you know how to add an application to a variety of Flipper Zero firmwares. Next, we'll look at the steps to remove a menu item. So for example, if NFC, you didn't want to show up in the list. I'll right click on Flipper Apps and say Peak Definition. And scrolling down to NFC, we can see the name is NFC all caps and the app ID is NFC lowercase for this firmware. So before the menu add item call, you're going to want to say if strcomp, and then in this case, we're going to do NFC all caps, and then flipper underscore apps sub I, and the all caps version is the dot name, and we'll say equals equals zero. And if that happens, we'll say continue semicolon. And what continue does is just goes to the next item in the loop. The code will still be taking space on your flipper, but the menu item will be gone. So now you know how to add and remove applications from the Flipper Zero for various firmwares. In my next customization video, we'll look at how to change the look and feel of the main menu. Roguemaster and Extreme both support the Wii Grid format of the main menu, which lists up to 6 blocks. We'll be creating our own UI experience. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below.